the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese.
Hello there, elementaries. We have a challenging lesson for you today here on Chinese Pod. Come to you from Shanghai, China. My name would also be Ken Carroll.
I am Jenny.
Hello, Jenny.
I am me.
Yes, you are. And today we're looking at the directory assistants.
Oh, I love that. When you dial the magical number.
You dial the magical number.
And they connect you to everything.
That's right. Now, in the States, that number is actually, I think it's 411, is it? 411?
But that's here what John informs us.
I think so, yeah. Mm. And here it's 114.
114.
114. Right, so that's 114. Now, this is fairly mechanical stuff here.
Yes.
This is what you hear, and this is why I think it could be interesting. We'll go through it.
Yeah.
Well, you know, you'll get to understand it. Mm. Some of it is slightly formal, but it's real.
Yes.
And then what you can do is you can call.
You have to call them.
And try talking
yes.
to them.
Mm.
Now, I know that there's like something like 100,000 people listening and regularly using Chinese. So don't all call at once, okay? Or Yao Yao Si will
get Oh, you can.
Younger.
Then you will get to hear that Kenny G tune. Because when the number, the oh. line gets busy, they
oh,
play
God.
You the Kenny G tune.
No, I wouldn't wish that on anyone. But anyway, so Yao Yao Si, if you're out, I don't know how you would call Yao Yao Si from outside China. But anyway,
you would dial the country code and then
yeah.
dial any city code. And Yao Yao Si. It's
well,
a national number.
There
yeah.
you go. That's excellent. So this is real life stuff. This is what you'll hear. Let's see. Sit back and see what you can figure out. Some of the expressions are a little bit specific,
yeah.
but actually they're made up of common elements, and mm. that's the interesting part. So let's listen three times and then we'll take it apart.
对话第一遍欢迎拨打114茶号台工号709为您服务请讲
工商银行电话和地址
知道哪个区吗?
市中心的
好的,请记录
第二遍
欢迎拨打114茶号台 工号709 为您服务 请讲
工商银行电话和地址
知道哪个区吗?
市中心的
好的,请记录
第三遍
欢迎拨打114茶号台 工号709 为您服务 请讲
工商银行电话和地址
知道哪个区吗?
市中心的
好的,请记录
Now, there's a lot here. Let's go through it. Yeah, we'll do the translation now. Okay.
欢迎拨打114茶号台,工号709,为您服务,请讲.
Thank you for dialing 114 Directory Assistance, employee number 709 at your service. Please go ahead.
欢迎拨打114茶号台,工号709,为您服务, 请讲.
Thank you for dialing 114 Directory Assistance. Employee number 709 at your service. Please go ahead.
欢迎拨打114茶号台,工号709,为您服务,请讲. 工商银行电话和地址.
I'm looking for the Industry and Commerce Bank telephone number and address.
工商银行电话和地址.
The Industry and Commerce Bank's telephone number and address.
工商银行电话和地址. 知道哪个区吗?
Which district?
知道哪个区吗?
Do you know the district?
知道哪个区吗? 市中心的.
Yeah, downtown.
市中心的.
Downtown.
市中心的. 好的. 请记录.
Okay, please take this down.
好的,请记录.
All right, please make a note.
好的,请记录.
Now, there's so much here. The first expression I'd like to look at is to dial, and that is
拨打. 拨打
first tone and third tone. Yes. Now that's formal, right?
Yes.
That's the way an operator talks to you.
Exactly. Okay.
So 拨打, and then you'll hear that a lot, you know, when you're dialing through, you're doing any of that stuff. So that's the 拨打, it's the it's useful phrase. 114 we had. Now we had the directory assistance, and that's called
查号台.
Now, Chinese is so logical at times, right? So the elements here are the three. Could you tell us those three elements, please?
查号台. The first one, 查, means to search.
Yes.
And 号, numbers.
Yes.
台 is like a counter.
A desk or a counter, yeah. So 查, as in, you also use that to search in a dictionary, don't you?
Yes.
You say, for example,
查字典.
查字典, so it's the same 查. How as in the number, 台柜台的台. So again, all together, so that's called the
查号台.
There you go, 查号台. Now, employee number 709.
工号709. 工号709.
Now, 709, you can figure that out. That's the number 709.
709?
But this expression, 工号, tell us about this.
Means employee number.
Employee number. Is this from the old socialist days, or is it also...
It's still being used now. I think it's from the old days.
Okay.
Welcome back to another installment of Chinese Pod Trivia. And the question for you is, for what test does ChinesePod offer preparation services for? Is it A, the polygraph, B, the colonoscopy, C, the HSK test, or D, the CAT scan?
The CAT scan?
Ooh, sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, the HSK test. That's right, ChinesePod will thoroughly prepare you to pass this rigorous test of proficiency in Chinese. ChinesePod.com/HSK.
And so it's even used in like very, very international companies. I
wouldn't say, maybe service industry
will have
Gonghao. If you go to a bank,
you'll see those
little name cards. And
yeah, or a little plaque maybe there. And it says that the employee's photo is his Gonghao.
Gonghao.
Now, this Gong is literally 工作的工, right?
Yes.
So it means
work.
All right. So employee number. And here's a good little expression, at your service.
为您服务.
At your service.
Yes.
Jenny, 为您服务. There you go. And dear gentle listener, Jenny and I are always
为您服务.
And I notice it's the 您, which is the formal.
Yes. Okay. The respectful.
Just always remember, 我们为您服务.
对.
We're always at your service.
对.
Now, don't get too carried away. So, Industry and Commerce Bank, how do we say that?
工商银行. 工商银行.
工商银行. Now, 银行 meaning bank.
Bank.
And once again, we have this where you put these elements together. So you have 工商, 工 meaning...
工业. Industry.
Yeah.
And 商, 商业, commerce.
Okay.
So 工商银行, ICBC, Industrial and Commercial Bank of China.
So 工业的工, okay.
也是工作的工.
Yes, yes. And the word 商 essentially means business, doesn't
yes.
it? Or does it mean trade?
Trade, business.
Okay. 电话和地址, meaning phone number and address. Okay. Now, the question, do you know which district? Which district is that? The question was?
知道. 哪个区吗? 知道哪个区吗?
Now, 区, first tone, means...
Yes. District.
District, in a city district.
Yes, this is how Chinese cities are arranged.
Yes.
Divided up to different districts.
Yes, indeed. The character kind of makes sense as well. It's kind of
if you can see it.
There's like an X inside a box, and it indicates...
drawing the boundary.
Yes, indeed. So, 区. Now... I found this next sentence slightly confusing. Could we hear it?
市中心的, 市中心的.
Now, 市, here is the fourth tone, right? But it sounds like the verb 市,
to be.
But in fact, it's the other 市, meaning
city.
城市的市,
yes.
Right? And so what it means now, 中心, you may know, means
center.
Center or HQ. Mm. Literally translated, it means middle heart.
Yes.
Right?
Middle
中心,
heart.
Now, so, 是, as in 城市的市, mm. the city center heart.
Yes.
Which would be the downtown branch, or maybe the HQ, the city HQ, you could also say. Mm. Now, this is a great, take this down, this is a great expression.
请记录。请记录。请记录。
Mm. Now, 记录 is a really interesting little expression
yes.
here. The two characters, could you tell us something about those?
记 means to remember.
To remember.
录 means to record.
To record. Yeah. So, 我记得, it's the same, you know, mm. I remember. 记, right, fourth mm. tone. And 录 is also fourth tone. It
yes.
means to record. Now, the word, in fact, for a TV, like a documentary, is also called a...
记录片。记录片。
纪录片, mm. So there you go, it's a documentary.
Yes.
That's your way to remember that mm. one. So write it down. So again, this is a language you'll hear in the context of talking to somebody at directory assistance. It's the real stuff. It's
yes.
the authentic stuff. Mm. And that's what we try to bring you, practical and authentic. So as I said, if you get the chance to try after you've practiced here a few mm. times, give Yao Yao a call.
Yes.
Let's listen to that three more times.
对话第一遍。欢迎拨打幺幺四查号台，工号七零九，为您服务。请讲。工商银行电话和地址。知道哪个区吗？市中心的。好的，请记录。第二遍。欢迎拨打幺幺四查号台。
工号七零九，为您服务。请讲。工商银行电话和地址。知道哪个区吗？市中心的。好的，请记录。第三遍。欢迎拨打幺幺四查号台。工号七零九，为您服务。请讲。
工商银行电话和地址。知道哪个区吗？市中心的。好的，请记录。
Okay, well, I think we've been through the rigors of that one.
Yes.
We'll be back again tomorrow with yet
another
fresh
dialogue. Lesson.
In the meantime, go to ChinesePod.com and explore the language. Mm. And it's always, I mean, the visual thing is really important, I think.
Yes.
Even here for this, for me in this dialogue, I saw relationships between characters that I didn't even mm. know were the same character.
Yeah.
And that's always happens in Chinese. And it helps you to build, to reinforce those links between your synapses mm. so you remember.
That's
anyway
deep.
Yes. Anyway, we'll be back in with another lesson tomorrow, but right now, Jenny, it's time for us to say
再见.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number
0525.
So just go to www.chinesepod.com/0525 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/0525.